Hello students, in our second chapter we have done pure substances and now next is impure substances. Impure means which are not pure and this is also known as mixtures. Mixtures are the substances which are made of two or more elements same as compounds or compounds or any substance mixed in any ratio by mass. So in compound we have done made of two or more elements combining fixed ratio. Here it is in any ratio by mass. So this is the main difference between mixtures and compounds for their ratio. For example, we can take the mixture of salt and water. And how we will explain it? This is container A, this is container B, and this is container C. I am taking here three containers and in every container putting 100 ml water. This is 100 ml water. In every container 100 ml water. Now, in container A, I will put 1 spoon salt, in container B 2 spoon and container 3 5 spoon salt. Mix in it. When we mix salt in it, we cannot see it. It looks like simple water, but we can check it by tasting. When we taste this water, then only we can know that how much salt is dissolved in given water. Both mix together, so these three are mixtures. But ratio is not fixed. We have not take fixed ratio. Means 100 ml water we are taking. If we take 10 ml water, 50 ml water and adding salt in that, it will again called salty water. We are taking 100 ml water and adding this much salt, it is again calling salty water. So for mixtures, components are not fixed by mass. Example can be anything: salt plus water, sugar plus water, ink plus water, or we are adding salt in vegetable for cooking, we are adding salt plus sugar, we are adding different gases in atmosphere, adding dust particles, smoke particles or other gases in atmosphere, air. So these all are different kind of mixtures. Where two or more components are mixed but their ratio is not fixed. Okay, now definition is clear. Next come to its characteristics, main features of mixtures. First one, components mixed in any ratio. So they are not in fixed ratio. We can take any how much we want to take. If we need less salt, when we add less salt. If we need more, then we can add more. Both will be called mixtures. Next is, components are not chemically bound. These chemical components, let's take example of salt and water for everything. Every property we are taking here the example of salt and water. So first point clear, second, not chemically bound. Chemically bound means, if chemically bound, then chemical change will be there, then new substance should be formed. But here new substance is not formed. Salt, table salt formula is NaCl and this H2O. Simply when we mix these two, it will become saline water, salty water only. No any other chemical will be formed. So it is not chemically bounded. components do not lose their identity. These components will not lose their identity. Means salt will remain salt, it will not become sugar or anything. Water will remain water as a liquid. So they will not lose their identity. Homogeneous or heterogeneous in nature. Mixtures can be homogeneous or heterogeneous. If we are adding salt in water, it is homogeneous. It is because it is clear solution. We cannot see the components in it. That where is salt, where is water. But when we take sand plus water or soil plus water, then what happens? We can see soil particles. We can see soil particles after some time settling on the bottom of the beaker. So this is in heterogeneous mixture and this one is homogeneous mixture. Next point is the melting point and boiling point of mixtures are not fixed because they do not contain components in fixed ratio. If fixed ratio is taken every time, then only fixed melting point or fixed boiling point can occur. But if we are taking case of mixture, then ratio is not fixed, so melting point and boiling point will not be fixed. It will vary, it will change according to the amount of these two we have taken. Next property is, property of mixtures are properties of its components. Now see, this is salty water. So what is the property of this mixture? When we see it, it is in liquid phase, liquid state. When we taste it, it is salty. And the property of its components, salt and water. Salt is salty, water is liquid. So these two were the properties of its components. These properties not change. Then we take example of sugar and water. Then sugar is sweet, water is liquid. When we are taking example of ink plus water, then ink will show its color and water will show its liquid nature. So they will not lose their identity. Even in case of sand and water, sand is solid, it not mix, then it settle down. We can see its brown color substance in it and water is liquid. So these were the properties that not change. So properties of mixture are the properties of its components. You can easily tell me now, if I will add lemon in water, yes, this is also mixture. Will properties of lemon and water change or not? Yes, sure, it is not changed. Because due to lemon, sour taste is there, and due to water, liquid nature is there. And if we add in that salt also, then salt will also give its taste. If we add sugar in that, then sugar will also give its taste. If we add meat in that, mint is pudina, then it will also give its smell and taste in that. So when we are making lemonade or lemon juice, all these components are showing their properties. So this point I think it is clear to you. Next is, when mixtures are made, no or very little energy changes take place. When we made this mixture of salt and water, then what we do? Simply put 1 spoon of salt in water and stir it. There is no heating we have done. So when we will not heat this, energy is not absorbed or energy is not released.
and salt mixes water easily. In this case, we can say no energy changes takes place. Sometimes what happens when we want to add sugar in milk, what we do? We heat it for some time. Then means we are taking hot milk. Then sugar dissolves faster. Sugar can dissolve in cold milk also. But when temperature is high, diffusion is high and it mixes easily and fastly. How will this happen? That time little energy changes takes place. So in case of mixtures, no or very little energy changes take place. And the last property is components can be easily separated by simple physical methods. Which components? Mixture components. Here we have taken salty water. Now you can do it at your home also. Take some water, put some salt in it and mix it properly. Then it will be a mixture, salty water mixture. Now you have to separate its components. Then simply what will you do? You will heat that mixture. This beaker, salty water, you just heat it over burner. Then what will happen? Water will evaporate and only salt will remain here. So this way we can easily separate the components of this salty water. Salt and water separated. In case of sand and water, again it is easy. You can take any cloth for filtering this water, and when you filter this, then what happens? Sand particles remain on cloth and water comes below in this container. So here also we separate the components of these mixtures very easily. So these all were the properties, and in last topic we have done the properties of compounds. Now you can compare compounds and mixtures easily on the basis of their properties or characteristics, and then you will well understand the difference. Try to write the difference between compounds and mixtures. Okay, and in next topic we will continue with types of mixtures.